Hello, Year 2 students. Welcome back. My name is Ella, and I am your teacher today. Right, let's have a think about what we need for today's lesson. We will need our learning book. Lots of really valuable learning going on in this book, and well done to you. We'll need our hundreds, tens, and ones. We've made them, but I will be using our wooden blocks, just the same as yours where you are. And a pack of cards, our trusty, faithful pack of cards. Today's learning intention is to partition numbers to solve addition problems. And we'll know how to do that when we partition both numbers in tens and ones to add together to make our total. All right, so what does that look like? I heard what it sounded like, but what does that look like? So let's have a look at the example I have in front of me. I have the numbers 46 and I have the number 23. I'm going to partition both numbers in tens and ones to make our total. So I have 4 tens and 2 tens. 4 and 2 will give me 6. I have 6 tens, and to bring my ones across, I have 6 and 3. 6 and 3 will give me 9. My answer is 69. Well done. That's how I add the two numbers together. Okay, now let's see what that looks like when we make it and write it. Let's get to three examples now. So we have 48 plus 31. Now remember, you can make these and you can move those around for your own learning. I'm going to show you a different way of looking at this too. So we have 48. Let's partition 48 into tens and ones. So 40 plus 8. We know that 48 is 40 plus 8. And let's have a look at 31. 31 is 30 and 1. So we've partitioned both numbers now into tens and ones. And I'm just going to use a little bridge so I can put these two numbers together. So I can put these two numbers, 30 and 40, into 70. Bring my tens together, and I'm going to bring my ones together. So I can see that 8 and 1 is 9. Quite tricky. And now I've partitioned both numbers and brought my tens and ones together. I can now finish my sentence. This is 70 plus 9, 79. So my answer above here is 79. And I've arrived there because I've been able to partition both numbers and then bring my tens and bring my ones together. What wonderful maths. Let's try again. 27. 27 is a 20 plus a 7. That's how we make 27 in tens and ones. Let's look over here. 61. Well, 61 is partitioned into 60 and 1. Okay, now to finish our number sentence, let's put our tens together. 20 plus 60 is 2 and 6, 8 is 80. And let's put our ones together. 7 and 1, 1 more than 7 is 8. Okay, let's run along here. Now I've got my tens together and my ones together. I can see that my answer is 88. So 27 and 61 is 88. Now we're cooking. Well done. Let's try one more. And I think you could probably do this one without me. I've got some examples ready for you to do in your learning books. So let's finish this one off together. 74 plus 25. The first thing we do is partition. We're partitioning both numbers. So let's have a look. What's 74? It's 70 plus 4. And what's 25? I could make it if I'm not sure. 25 is 20 and 5. All right, the next step is to pop my tens together. 70 and 20, 7 and 2, 79, is 90. And let's pop my ones together. 4 and 5. Oh, that's a near double. 4 and 5. 4 and 5 make 9. And I have this fabulous answer of 99. So 74 and 25 make 99. And that is a really effective way of being able to put two-digit numbers together in an addition sentence. So let's get to your work. Let's have a look at our doing task today. It's not really work, is it? It's good fun. So here we are. We have 5 sums for us to do in our learning books. And remember, what we want to do is pull out the tens and ones, pull out the tens and ones, and then add them together, just like I've shown you. So press pause and pop these into your learning book. And don't forget to show us your learning. Write down how you're getting your answer. Okay, so let's think about what we learnt today. In our reflection, we've discovered that when we're adding two numbers together, we can pull out the tens, put them together, and we can pull out the ones and put them together. And it's a really efficient way to do our addition number sentences. And all of that learning should be in your learning book now. Okay, a takeaway task? I thought so. Let's play us versus them again, but this time will be a little bit different. Let me show you. Remember, we're going to take out the tens and the picture cards and the joker. All right, so that just keeps the game simple. Some people like to change the game, and you might like to too, but to start with, we keep it nice and simple. Okay, so this time I'm going to put my cards down. And I'm allowed to move them around. I'm allowed to make them as big as I can get them. So let's have a look. Us versus them. We've got 65. Well, us, if I move this around, I'd make it smaller. So I'm going to leave that there. 65 is the biggest number us can make. But them, 79. I can move that and still win. So now I have 65 is the largest number on this side and 97 is the largest number on that side. Congratulations to them. Let's try again. Us, 88, what an interesting number. And 97. Well, look what's happened. This is the largest number I can make. It's the same. And this is the largest number I can make. The 9's in the 10's and the 7 is in the 1's. If I turned it around, I'd actually make it smaller. So once again, the mighty them seems to have won that. One more before you take off to play your own us versus them game. Let's have a good look. Oh, it's another double, another 5 and a 5. I can't do much about that. That stays the same whether they are in the 10s or the 1s. And what would be bigger, 61 or 16? That's right. I'm going to leave the 6 in the 10s column. That makes it the biggest number it can be. And a victory for us. Us wins and we continue to play. So we're making the biggest number we can, and remember, the biggest number always wins. So enjoy our us versus them game. Use all your cards up, play again, teach someone else to play how us versus them, or you can make up your own additions to that game. Not sure what they would be, but it would be very creative maths, wouldn't it? Okay. Thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you at our next lesson. Goodbye, powerful mathematicians.